Humans are believed to be the most technologically advanced civilization that's ever set foot on Earth, or really anywhere in the solar system. But are we the first? Could there have been an advanced civilization that walked the Earth millions or even billions of years ago and then died out long ago, their technology and structures lost to the eons? How can we know? In the last 100,000 years or so, modern humans like you and me evolved here on Earth from our ancestors. We started out in Africa, but then over thousands of years, we migrated to every corner of the planet. Our impact on this world is clearly visible. You could see it in the air, across the land, the oceans, and even out in space. Humanity is a technological civilization, and we're bending this planet to our will. If an alien was dropped down in the middle of a modern human city, it would be immediately obvious. But even in the most remote places on Earth, the right scientific instruments would show our impact on the water and atmosphere of our planet. But if humanity suddenly disappeared from Earth, our planet would reclaim it. Plants and animals would recolonize our spaces. The sun, wind, and rain would weather down our buildings and monuments. The natural cycles of the planet would clear out the evidence that we were ever here. Eventually, plate tectonics itself would drag evidence of human existence down into the mantle, destroying it forever. Fast forward a few hundred million or billion years into the future, and it would be almost impossible to know humans were ever here. Which makes us wonder, could we know if we're actually the first advanced civilization to live here on Earth? If another civilization came before us, how could we find them? This is a question that Dr. Jason Wright, an exoplanet researcher and associate professor at Penn State University, posed in his 2017 paper titled Prior Indigenous Technological Species. And the paper is all about where we might find evidence for previous advanced civilizations here in the solar system and what might have happened to them. Now, before I get started, let me be clear, don't get your hopes up. There isn't a single piece of evidence anywhere at all that there was ever another civilization. But we've only scratched the surface of exploring our solar system. In fact, we've barely even explored our own planet, and conditions could have been different in the past. The probes and rovers exploring other worlds in the solar system have told us that the conditions we see today is just a phase the planets are going through. Billions of years ago, the sun was cooler, Venus was probably less terrible, Mars was warmer and wetter, and more places in the solar system could have been habitable. Perhaps an ancient civilization could have survived on one of those worlds, or even the early Earth, and then became a spacefaring species, spreading to other worlds in the solar system. In order to search for those ancient civilizations, consider what kinds of impact humans are leaving on the Earth. That'll be the first place to search, since it's easiest to get to. But Earth is active, and the surface is under constant weathering. Open pit mines, where intelligent species dug out valuable minerals, would have filled in or been weathered away. Radioactive isotopes from ancient nuclear reactors could be visible for hundreds of thousands or millions of years, but eventually they'd decay. And over the longest timescales, the Earth's shifting plate tectonics would obscure almost any sign. But the Earth also keeps a history of its atmosphere and water in the geologic record. The pollution from an advanced civilization could be stored in those layers of sediment over vast periods of time. According to Gavin Schmidt and Adam Frank in their new paper called The Silurian Hypothesis, which, yes, is named after the lizard-like Silurians from Doctor Who, there could be signals in the geologic record. They explain how little we actually know about the ancient Earth. The oldest part of the Earth's surface is in the Negev Desert in southern Israel, which is only 1.8 million years old. There are older surfaces from mining or exposure and uplift, but you have to go looking for it. There's no part of the ocean floor that's older than 170 million years old. Since only a fraction of living creatures that have ever existed would show up on the fossil record, Schmidt and Frank say that any civilizations that didn't last longer than about 4 million years wouldn't show up in the fossil record for more than a blip. Blink, and you most likely miss it. But what about the chemicals humans have been putting into the air? Humans have released 500 billion tons of carbon into the atmosphere over the last couple of centuries, and that's adding a layer to the geologic record that could be detectable for millions or even billions of years into the future. And not just carbon, we're also emitting trace elements like lead, chromium, and even gold, which will be more concentrated than what you'd randomly detect if it all formed naturally on Earth. Humans have even changed the fossil record itself, increasing the number of species that hang out with us, like mice and rats, and killing off the megafauna. And that might be detectable as well. In other words, if future civilizations looked carefully, there would be evidence of humanity's presence long after all the other evidence had weathered away. Perhaps if we look carefully, we'll eventually find evidence of an ancient civilization that was destroyed eons ago. But what if they knew they wouldn't be around forever and wanted to leave some record of their existence? We'll get to that in a second, but first I'd like to thank Mark Stephen, Michael Halada, Tim Rump, Tanglebones, Clint Branham, Maris Williams, and the rest of our 829 patrons for their generous support. If you love what we're doing, you want to get in on the action, head over to patreon.com/universetoday. Let's say an ancient civilization knew that they weren't long for the solar system and wanted to leave some kind of evidence for us to find, to know that they were here long ago. What should we be looking for? If a civilization wanted to be remembered, Jason Wright says that other places in the solar system would be better preserved. There's no wind or water erosion on the moon, just the radiation from the sun and the constant stream of micrometeorite impacts that churn up the surface. Mars has more weathering, but still, there are features largely unchanged over vast periods of time. Of course, an ancient factory could get covered in dust or worn down by erosion and look like a rocky outcrop. The best evidence is probably underground, safely protected from the ongoing surface erosion. But we need orbiters or rovers with ground-penetrating radar to peer beneath the surface. For example, NASA's Europa Clipper is going to be equipped with an ice-penetrating radar instrument that should be able to peer kilometers beneath the thick ice on the Jovian moon. There could even be free-floating objects in the solar system, like ancient space stations. They'd have been abandoned long ago and they probably wouldn't work anymore. The micrometeorites and solar radiation would be working hard to wear them down. But we see comets and asteroids which are relics from the early solar system, largely untouched over billions of years. The golden records on board the Voyager spacecraft were designed to last at least a billion years, long enough for the spacecraft to cross almost the entire Milky Way at their current speed. What if an advanced civilization purposefully gathered their knowledge and evidence of their existence and put it out into space where we could find it? Although this sounds like a pretty crazy idea, in fact, humans are working on something like this right now. There's a group called the Arch Mission Foundation, and they want to archive the knowledge of humanity and store it on the moon. If all goes well, a rocket launched to the moon in 2020 will be carrying an astrobotic Peregrine lunar lander. Once the lander settles down on the moon, it'll be safe and sound for billions of years for any future civilizations to learn about our history. It'll be carrying the entire contents of Wikipedia, as well as a compilation of human languages and other content embedded into a microfiche that you could read if you had a 1,000 times magnification microscope. I know, you're wondering what would happen if it gets hit by a stray meteor. And that's why the Arch Mission Foundation would like to build more and spread them across the solar system to preserve the legacy of humanity for our future robotic overlords to enjoy. If they're there, why haven't we found them? In their 2012 paper titled On the Likelihood of Non-Terrestrial Artifacts in the Solar System, Jacob Hak-Misra and Ravi Kumar Koparu calculate how difficult it would be to find artificial objects in the solar system. Space is big, and it's hard to find things unless you know exactly where to look. If there was a 1 to 10 meter space probe out there in the solar system containing the total knowledge of an advanced civilization, there's almost no chance we'd find it with the state of our current exploration. Maybe something on the moon or Mars would turn up, but imagine if they put it in a nice, stable Lagrange point or out of the Kuiper Belt to minimize the damage from solar radiation and asteroid impacts. Clearly, we need to explore more of the solar system. But you know what would look better than a lander? A monolith. Imagine if we put those across all the worlds in the solar system with instructions about which worlds are yours except Europa. Just saying. So are we the first advanced civilization here in the solar system? Probably. We haven't found any others, but there are places we can look and techniques we can use to find out anyone who's here before us. So what do you think? Are we the first in the solar system? What kinds of monuments would you build to let future civilizations know that we were here? Let me know your thoughts in the comments. Once a week, I gather up all my space news into a single email newsletter and send it out. It's got pictures, brief highlights about the story, and links so you can find out more. Go to universetoday.com/newsletter to sign up. Now, here's a playlist.